What's happening, gamers? This is the new Amphinix once again, and welcome back to Let's Play Super Ghouls and Ghosts. Now we're in the third stage, and in our last episode, we have completed the graveyard and the pirate ship. Graveyard, of course. And now we're headed into the Crucible of Flame, the third stage. Actually, to me, though this stage is pretty hard, though it gets pretty hard right here, I think that this stage is one of the best designed stages in this game. And the theme song of the stage fits it all. One thing I hate about this stage, those little flying Red Arremers and the Woo. Oh, I can't stand them and the Woo in this game. Ugh, stupid Woo. Ugh, fire breath. Brush your teeth, bro. I think he was eating too many tacos with extra hot sauce. And I love my Mexican food. Look at those platforms. I just love how they drip blood in this one. They look so cool. You gotta be careful because right now you're in a sea of lava, but it's gonna get harder from now on. And now it's time for you to present a monster that I hate in this game with all my core. Ladies and gentlemen, the Red Arremer Ace. However, you can get to play as the Red Arremer Ace in the spin-off of the Ghosts and Goblins saga, which is Gargoyle's Quest. However, Firebrand is the main character, as he is called the Red Arremer Ace. Get off me, stupid bat. Go back to the bat cave. Oh, you bastard. Ugh, killed by a statue. Such ridiculousness. Now it's time to go up the tower and recover everything I lost. But still, even if you don't have the gold armor, the dagger is still the coolest weapon in the game. As you can say that in Castlevania, the coolest weapon in the game is, of course, the Holy Cross. And my second favorite sub-weapon in Castlevania is the Holy Water. My third favorite is the stopwatch, in fourth place, the axe. And my least favorite one is the dagger in Castlevania. Funny how in this game, you know, it's actually funny how in this game, the dagger is more useful than the one you see in Castlevania. Well, sometimes it's useful, sometimes it's not. Sometimes you can't bother about getting a huge bag of money. Oh, goblins! I hate those things! Ugh, that was close. And also, I have to tell you, gamers, that the higher your score, you can get more lives in this game. Whoa! What the heck? Yes! Now we're talking. You know, the green armor is called the bronze armor. I don't get it. Why is it bronze? Shouldn't it be called like a silver armor or something? Okay. Now we're gonna get to the boss of this stage. When I was a kid and I played this game and I got to this boss, my sister was so funny, screaming like, "Whoa, what is this? What is this? What is this?" As if she was riding a freaking roller coaster on Six Flags Great Adventure. You better watch out when he spit, when this giant snake spits the rocks to the side instead of up and in the top as well. But I kick his ass in no time. I'll show you. Gotcha. Take a key for coming in. Next stage. Okay, now we're inside a monster's stomach or something. You have to watch out for those tricky treasures that, well, I don't refer to the mimics, but some treasures contain magicians inside that'll turn you into a girl, or a bee, or a baby. Those guys always pissed me off when I was a kid, because they're the ones that give you the most trouble, you know what I'm saying? You know, I've seen so many Super Ghouls and Ghosts walkthroughs that have no commentary, and I actually enjoy doing a commentary of this game. Oh god. Whoa! Close call. Okay, here you go. Ugh. I don't know where the heck these monsters come from, but they piss me off. Big time. Okay. There you go. And I got 9 lives. Okay. Nope. Ah, the gold. Gold. Yes. That's what I call pimp my armor. Okay, this is the part I hate the most of this freaking stage. The freaking smoke vapor and all those bloated monsters that appear like the ones in the first stage. Cause they're the ones that give you the most trouble. Well, in this game, some bosses are easy. Others can be tough. Huh, and the little red Arremers give you the most trouble as well. Oh no. Hey, I crouched. I was careless. That's a funny thing about Super Ghouls and Ghosts, that Arthur fights naked. When he's stripped of his armor. So as you can see, Knight Arthur is one of my favorite heroes, video game heroes of course, and he has been slaying a lot of evil monsters long before Sir Daniel, Raziel, and Dante ever existed. Since I mentioned about Sir Daniel and Dante in the first video of this Let's Play, Raziel, as you all know, he's from Legacy of Cain, Blood Soul Reaver, and Blood Omen. And now, the boss of the stage is the Hydra. He's pretty easy to beat. Huh, Kratos would kick this guy's ass in one blow. I mean, Kratos from God of War, he would kick this guy's ass in the most brutal, epic fashion. Okay, here you go. You're inside a monster's heart, and now you're killing a Hydra. Come on. Uh-oh. You take too long to kill this monster, then this monster's gonna... Thank you. Please pardon the noise, it was Princess Zelda who was talking with Link. Now see ya, gamers!